Okay, hello everybody, welcome back to my channel today. And today we are back to our economic topic. So my topic today is talking about the resource of our planet. Is this enough for us to can use this for eternity, or we will go in to use another resource? So in the case if we don't have enough resource in the planet, where the resource we should use? Of course, we will use the resource from the universe. And for that, today we are going to talking about what if we're going to running out of resource and how that we're going to solve that. Let's go to see what did we have today. Okay, so to knowing about how that we're losing the resource, so I should tell you that the Earth can only replace some of the resource that people on the world using each year. And for that, a group named the Global Food Link Network have going to try to calculate the day each year we start using the resource that cannot be replaced. And for that, the group calculated how much we use by looking at everything that people using on the world. And for that, they include the resources such as the forest place, capacity to suck up the carbon dioxide. And also, they have calculating that how many earth that people will need to can have a healthy life on earth. If everyone, which means 100% of people on the earth, have the same lifestyle of the people in the richest country. So, some richest country that I'm saying for, is have calculated in 2019, and the sum of them, the first one is United States. If all the people on the world have the same rich as the United States, so the earth that we will need to can live healthily, we're going to be 5 Earths. If this is the Australia, we will need 4.1 Earth. And for that, Russia is 3.2 Earth, Japan is 2.8 Earth, United Kingdom is 2.7 Earth, and China just 2.2 Earth, of course, because there is going to talking about how much rich people on Earth will going to be and how much Earth that they need to can go in to make them consume enough thing, which means that if you are rich enough, like all of the people in the America, and if all people in the world rich like them, how many earth we will need to get them have a good life, okay? And for that, it is unlikely that we will ever need 5 earth as the demand of the resource going down and down. So the price will going to increase and rise very fast, because the resource that we have is not much anymore. And for that, it can lead to the poor of the resource and can make everybody have a hard life. So only for that, we know that we have to take another resource, but we only have one earth. So some people are suggesting another fix, that we're going to find a new planet, take the resource, take place, and trying to make more resource, which means that we're going to take the resource from the space and from the universe. For that, the solar system have contained more things that the technology of people in this world can go into consume now. Although space travel is very extremely expensive, which means that if you're going to take the resource from outside, you have to go to use many money for that. And for that, it's quite impossible if you don't reach enough, but this will going to be possible if the technology in the future going to improve. And for that, it will soon to become effective to can go to use to harvest the asteroid for minerals and new water, or going to set up the mine on the moon. Okay, so This is the way that we are going to use to can try to replace the resource in our Earth and take from the another planet. But which planet should we want to take? Because as you know, not all the planets in the world have the good resource. So, for example, the good planet would mean the asteroid named Cycle 16 is an asteroid that lies between Mars and Jupiter. And this is a very, very good planet. Or you can call it a very good asteroid because it's made entirely from metal and mostly iron, nickel, and gold. And for that, you can see if you're going to take the resource metal from this asteroid, you can go to use this for many, many years. And all of the money that the asteroids have is estimated to be the worth around $700 billion. Also, this is a very, very big number. And we can use this to can make our planet better when we take the resource of metal from the other planets. Because you know that the resource about metal is a best thing that we can use for people in our Earth. But this thing cannot go into be replaced. So if we are going to use so much metal on the Earth, the metal on the Earth will go into end up nothing. And for that, we don't have enough metal to can use it. So if we're using the asteroid to can go to take the resource of metal, gold, nickel, and iron on it, we can go in to make our planet better and have time to can replace our metal. Okay? And for that, this money that have to be worth for this asteroid enough to give each of 70.6 billion people on the Earth 90 million each people, which means that it's lost a lot of money. So this is how that we're going to take the resource from another planet. But do you think that we should go into moving and live on the other planet if we don't have enough space? Some economists think about this too, and they think that is moving on Mars is a good idea than just going to take the replace the resource on Moon and the other planet. So, the economic case for sending humans to Mars is a little harder to make because Mars is so far to the Earth. And for that, it could take many, many money and very expensive to can get to there, especially if you're going to take something with you. Because traveling in space, which means traveling with space travel, is not allowed people to using to carry things with them right now. Because it costs so much of money to can create the technology to can carry the things that the people want to take with. Okay? So there are many ways that we can take the resource cheaper than just going to move on the Mars. But also, if we don't have enough space on the Earth, moving on the Mars is a very, very valid option. And it can be very good for us to try to make the Mars become a new home. So maybe it's we trying to make our planet become another home about like Mars. So we have to finding out how to can make it like home. Like when the first time people traveling on the moon, they don't have any research about the permanent settlement yet. But they have created many, many inventions to can find out that if we can live on the other planet or not. And those invention. So they don't have any things can get the result when we can go to life on another planet. But this invention have made and produced many ideas to can make many inventions that make life on Earth still become better. And some of them is the solar panels. Some of them is the CIT scanner, the scaffold glass, and the wireless airport. Do you know the airport? I think the airport is a very important thing that because we don't have the wire like this. So this wire is not we're going to use anymore. It's become useless and we can use it freely. But also, anyway, the invention to going help people can travel and exploring the space, make many ideas for people on the Earth, can creating more and more invention that have life in a pattern. So, although we don't know that if we can live in the all the planet yet or not. But we still know that if we are keep going to invention, maybe someday we can create the technology to help us to can live on another planet. And now, this is the end of my video. Thank you for listening, and I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye!